Cool. We back. We back. We back. We back. We back.
Come I on. Don't own or promote this music. So don't sue me. This is not copyright. Nah, it's not mine, but I got to play it. This is how we're starting. If you know, you know.
You know, you know. This is how we do it. This is how we come back.
Why did I do this?
Oh, man. You lived and died by this song.
Oh, my goodness. We're going to get into that right now.
Yeah, this was Man Down. What is it? Hand Down, Man Down.
Hand Down, Man Down. Let's drop the drops, man.
If Andy can't help you.
Welcome to the We Working Fam podcast. Episode Fizzive 5-5.
Kobe, five rings.
Staying consistent, man. We're up early, too. So, hey, thank you for waking up. We're doing this for you guys. And we're just trying to stay consistent. And, man, we're having a blast doing this. In this episode, just letting you know, it's going to be jokes. Ain't nothing really going on this episode. It's a lot of laughs, so be prepared. I played Shaggy, if you want to give them a recap. Obviously, last Friday, I had the battle, epic battle with Zoma.
Zoma.
What are your thoughts about that?
All right, so Jesse.
I got my butt kicked, by the way.
Yeah, to follow up from last week, Jesse had his R&B battle on Instagram Live. And I had high hopes. You know, I went through my day just thinking in my head, like, you know, Jesse's got this. He's got this musical background. Like, he understands, like, the vibe, like, what to come back with. Somebody hits a shot on him or, like, you know, somebody outpaces him in a race. Like, you know, he'll turn it up. And, you know, Jesse let me down. You know how J. Cole has that song, I let Nas down. Jesse have a song called I Let Andy Down. So I was in the comments. Yeah. I was in the comments supporting, and I had to be honest, I had to be real. Like, Zoma came through with some heat. He cheated a little bit. But the worst part about it is that halfway through the battle, when we were all in the zone, we were feeling it. We were actually entertained. There was a lot of people. There was about 20-some people in there, which is not bad. Like, it was really good. It was family and friends. Jesse decides to play probably the worst song you could play. This dude played Shaggy. You can't play Shaggy in an R&B battle.
Hey, that's what that guy.
You just can't. I think all of us at that moment who were in the IG live with you, we just gave it to Zoma. It was over.
That was it.
Like, there was no coming back from that. And then, but you know, it's what? Like, Jesse, you redeemed yourself though, but it was after the battle was over and you took your loss like a man and you started playing some heat after. So I just think that your strategy should change because I know that you have another battle coming up, right?
Rematch.
Hip hop. Okay, hip hop.
Yeah, I'm gonna show you those songs after. I got my. Okay. Yeah, right. I'm coming off. So, yeah, my side of the story. It was a great battle. I think I was overly prepared. I should say. I think maybe I didn't come prepared. I was overly prepared. So, I wanted to be creative to play stuff that wasn't really popular or known, or maybe that wasn't the biggest hit, right? And he did so too, but I think his people knew more. And I think the crowd really went to the songs of knowing versus like how those songs were hitting back then, right? So it's more of popular opinion.
Mm-hmm.
So when I felt my back was against the wall, because I was like, man, these songs, it seems like they don't know these songs. So I need to play something that they know. So yeah. I was like, oh, they know Shaggy. I had that in there just in case. I played the Shaggy because I was trying to cater towards the audience, which I should have just stick to my guns. I had bangers on there. I should have just stick with the bangers. And he kind of mentally got me because he would play a Genuine song, which I had a Genuine song that I wanted to play later, even though it wasn't the same song. I didn't want to come back with the same artist. So then I had to be creative and try to play something else, right? And then he'll do another song. I'm like, oh, shoot, I have that same group too, but I have a different song. So we had almost a similar playlist, just different songs, but similar artists. So he got to me because I didn't want to play the same artist as he did, which I played in the later rounds, which were bigger songs than he played. So I should have just stuck to my guns, played what I had, didn't matter what he played. And I'm sure I would have won.
Yeah, man. Like you, I think your strategy, you have to stick to your strategy. And I think that you in a battle, it's like if somebody, it was like a rap battle. So if he was hitting you with those punchlines and hitting your gut, it's like, man, you got to started replying to the gut checks. Like, but instead of like sticking to your strategy and knowing you already had some punchlines for him, you're like, oh man, he hit me hard. I got to let him know how that felt instead of like, nah, I got something for you.
Yeah.
So tomorrow, you got to come with it.
Tomorrow, we're going to do East versus West. Since he won, he picked West Coast. It's going to be 90s. It's going to be epic. I think it's going to be the same time, 9 o'clock your guys's. Oh, 9 o'clock my time, 7 o'clock your guys's time.
All right, man. I'm going to be on that live. I'm going to be on those comments. I'm going to be like one of those dads, soccer dads with a sign up saying, hey, that's the homie right there.
See, the only thing, my concern is, and I'm letting you know this right now, I'm not making excuses.
Oh, no excuses.
I'm not. I hate excuses.
We don't do that over here.
However, me and you are, as much as we are from the West Coast.
Oh, we love East Coast.
We love East Coast.
Yeah.
But I feel like there's going to be a lot of West Coast bias because a lot of the audience that we are, that will be on there is from the West Coast. So I still have bangers. Like, I'm going to have heat.
I don't want to skew your playlist. I don't want to do that. But the moment he plays, let's say, I'm going to give you an example, like Ice Cube, Good Day, the chat is going to go crazy.
Yes.
No, still Dre Day, like he plays something like that, they're going to go crazy. Any Snoop song, they're going to go crazy. So my recommendation, and I don't, and you, this is just an opinion. You can do whatever you want. You got to play some New York, like, songs to transition throughout the country, not just in that region. Like I would like even some Jay-Z, some popular Jay-Z.
Yeah.
Some popular like Cameron, like an Old Boy or something like that.
Cameron's 2000 though. I'm in 90s.
Ah, 90s.
I have to do those late. Oh. I'll show you my Tribe Called Quest.
All you need is Notorious B.I.G.
You're done.
All right.
You see?
What's some Big Pun? Still not a play. I just crushed a lot.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm just saying, because the West Coast, we got a diverse environment over here. So, you know, you got the Hispanic people, you have Black people, Asians, but that song is just good around the whole world. So you should.
Right.
But, hey, you better win. That's all I'm saying. You better win. I might put some money up on this.
Ooh. Okay.
I'm going to put it in the chat. I'm going to say I got 20 on Jesse.
Appreciate it.
20 on Jesse.
I'm not going to let you down, man. I thank you for the support, and I'm going to stick to my game plan.
Right.
I might just start it off with Cream.
Oh. Hey, don't. He might be watching this. He's saying too much. The thing is, who went first?
I did.
You went first. Okay.
It was 3-2. It was 3-2 before we switched. I was up one.
Mm.
And then he came back the later rounds, and he outmatched. And yeah. I think that's when Blevins came too, and he put his opinion in. So I may have won earlier matches, but we don't know.
You set the rules early. You don't make the rules. You just know the rules. What'd you say?
Yeah. I don't make the rules. I just know the rules.
All right. Let's do this.
I'll follow them. All right. So this next, like I said last week, I had this burning question that I wanted to ask you.
Okay? I've actually been thinking about this because I've been like, thinking like, what is this? But I can't think of anything. And I'm not scared though. So shoot it.
And like I said, this is nothing. We need answers. We need answers. I need a great explanation because it hurts, man. It hurts when, you know, there's things I want to talk to you about and I can't go and talk to you about.
Okay.
Because you're not there for me. If Andy can't help you, you can't help me when it comes to this.
All right, let's see.
All right, I have this reverb effect, so I'm going to throw this on. Let's see how it goes. I'm going to talk in the voice that Blevins doesn't like. All right?
All right.
It started when you were a boy. Terrell Owens. John Elway. You were the biggest Broncos fan that I ever have known.
Mm-hmm.
Why? How did you lose the passion for the NFL?
Oh,
especially for getting your team the orange and blue? The floor is yours.
That's the question?
Yes.
Why did I lose the passion for the NFL?
Not even the NFL, I should say. I just say your team, because you're a big NFL Bronco. You yeah. love football. And that you don't even, you can't yeah. even watch a game.
Man, you know, yes, I like the Broncos. And I like the Broncos back, way back, Terrell Davis, John Elway days, Shannon Sharp, McCaffrey. Like, I loved all those players. Champ Bailey. And I think what happened is, to be honest with you, I fell out of love of like how the game moved. Like, I felt like it was a slower pace. Like, I think that's what it was. Like, I just got bored of the game, and I didn't catch on to like what a lot of people do now, and that is the fantasy football. Like, and I think that's what keeps it exciting for a lot of you guys. And I just didn't catch on to that. Like, I didn't feel like I had time to like do or pick the players and all that stuff. And then I didn't get into no leagues like you guys do. And then what really topped it off for me is how the NFL treated Kaepernick during his, kneeling down during the national anthem. Like, that just kind of turned me off a lot. And I haven't watched football since then. So it's been probably 5 years, 6 years since I've even turned on a football game. And it's not like I'm protesting it. It's just more of just, I really don't care for it. And I get what you're saying, because like, we would probably be able to talk and chat and talk about like players and like things like that back in the past. So I see what you're getting at. But I mean, we still got basketball.
Yeah, no, that's true.
We could talk about hockey, getting hockey, like, you know, start something new. But I'm not interested. I haven't even had a Sunday off to watch a Super Bowl, because I'm like, yeah, just put me to work, because I don't really, it's not for me.
We're gonna get you into fantasy, man. You're gonna fall in love for the game, because I think I was a little opposite of you. I think when you were really into football, I wasn't that much into. Like, I've been a Rams fan since 2001, 2099, I would say. That's when I fell in love with the Rams, right? Mm-hmm. I would watch football, but I would only watch what was on Channel 11 or whatever when they played, right?
Yeah.
So we couldn't afford like the NFL package. I don't even think the NFL package was out back then. I think it was like whatever was on the TV you had to watch. So
yeah,
I wasn't really able to watch all those Rams games. But I think as I got older, then I got into fantasy football, like, the love of football that I have, because there's so many different players, different teams. You fall in love with players versus the team, you know? And I think it's exciting when you're watching the game, because you have something on the line, even if it's $20. Like, something, being a man, having something on the line, even if it's, you know, competitive, for lunch.
It has a competitive edge. And I tried it. I think I've even tried fantasy NBA, but I gave up just because I was like, I didn't feel like I had the time to invest in it. I'm being honest. So maybe I could go give it another go, you know, this season, if there is a season, you know.
There should be. But yeah, that's what I wanted to talk about. Like, fantasy football is coming around. I'm excited. I'm sure a lot of people are excited, because, hey, it's good money. It's easy money sometimes. Because
how much? What's the most you've ever won?
500.
500. How many leagues do you play in?
I play in 3.
At a time?
At a time. I play in 250, maybe like $50 leagues. And then I'll play like in a $20 league. Mm-hmm. Zoma has a basic league.
I heard he cheats in there too.
He does?
That's what I heard.
Oh,
to the grapevine. Hey, if you're watching this, Zoma, I heard you had two, I don't know how it goes, but I heard you had two teams in that league, and like he was trading all the players to him, so he had all the players. Oh, and like since he owned the league, he would like okay those trades. That's what I heard, man.
Hey, that's crazy.
Through the grapevine.
No wonder no one wins.
Well, that's why, just to go back to your battle, I just heard about that after your battle. Oh, he cheated in there too? Oh, yeah, he cheats in here too. And I was like,
Oh, yeah. Dang.
The truth comes out.
You might have to speak about that.
Oh, you're going to have to address it right away.
Yeah.
When you talk to him.
I'll talk to him. But that's what it's $20. It was $20. But yeah, hopefully we'll get you in, man. I think we, you know, I'll be glad to show you the ropes, guide you. You know, they have a lot of mock drafts now where you could just mess around.
I'm a Broncos fan regardless. Like, I still like the Broncos. You know, they won a ring with Peyton Manning, so you know, that was a cool year. I caught a little bit of that game, so just because I was a fan still. But I know the last couple of years they've been a little trash. I still keep up with them, but I mean, that's it. Like, I'm not. If you get me into fantasy, I might pique interest again.
Okay. We'll see.
We'll see.
I'll have people get in your ear to, you know, guide you.
Who does Blevins play in it?
Blevins plays. He plays in his own. I played with Blevins in a few before.
Okay.
Yeah. So. You will get you in there. But that was my question, man. I didn't mean to, like, I know it was bigger than what it was.
I was stressed out all week, man. I couldn't sleep. I had to talk to my wife. I had to, like, do research. I created some burner accounts just to, like, get into some people's IGs and see what, you know, I was trying to snoop around.
You went back in 2007 just to see any old tweets that you
I logged into my old MySpace. I was like, dang, man. I read through some messages that I should have never sent.
Hey, which that leads into the perfect transition to my next question. What was the worst feeling you've had after a night out?
Man, my 20s all was, 20s. Yeah, it's really all in the 20s. But this one time that recently happened just about a year ago, my bachelor party, and then we've all had nights like this. My boys threw me an amazing bachelor party, and we went to Denver, Colorado. We were out there for like, I think, 3 days, and it was the last night that we were there, and you know, these guys were feeding me alcohol all night, like the friends that they should be, and I'm talking about mixing probably every single drink that's in the bar. In multiple bars till like 3-4 in the morning, and having an amazing night, enjoying each other, just vibing, right? But then I wake up in the hotel room. I'm staying with Jesse that night, and I'm thinking it is like the apocalypse. I think it's the end of the world. I'm thinking like I'm in ICU, and I'm feeling the pains that I've never felt in my life, like shocks through my body, piercing pains in my stomach. I feel like I have an ulcer. It's just probably one of the worst feelings I've ever had after a drinking night. And from what I remember in Jesse's story, and I think he should tell it because he'll tell it better than I will, but I was kind of like moaning and groaning like a old man, and like saying, I think I was saying my wife's name, right? Something like that. And I like, just to give you some a back, like a noise, I think I remember doing something like this, like, I think I was, I must have like was listening to some Master P. Yeah. So that was some of the nights. But I mean, in my early 20s, mid 20s, all of my 20s, like I felt like I was able to deal with those nights a lot better. And I had plenty of those nights. I don't condone it, but you know, sometimes you got to go through some experiences, and then you do that stuff with some people that you love and you trust. So luckily that night I had a good friend with me, and he took care of me. But yeah, that was probably my worst my worst night. And what was your, what, hold on, but what, since you were there, what was your experience with me in that moment? Because you were there.
Well, I think us reflecting on our past, right? Because if you remember, we did, once I'm in our 20s, we did 6 shots of Patron in a row in at Vegas.
And no, then we you did it in 45 seconds. I did it in 3 minutes. So you're another level.
And we were good. We were good. You know, we went out, party that night. So it being your bachelor party, and we wanted you to take 6 shots. You took 6 shots of whiskey.
Yeah.
And you took it straight. And yeah, we were giving you crazy drinks, and we were drinking all night. We were drinking with you. I think, yeah, you took those extra 6 shots. However, we were just taking shots after shots with you. Crazy. And it was just us in the bar. Well, it was probably us and about 3-4 other people. The bar was really empty, and we were able to maximize this and just have fun. We had all the bartenders' attention. They were taking care of you. They knew why you were here. They're like, yeah, hey, he's here for a reason. And they took care of that reason. And obviously we got home safely. And yeah, I woke up to, I'm like, I didn't know what was going on. And then it just got louder. And he was just like, what's wrong? Are you okay? No. Oh my goodness. Poor guy. You felt it for what, 2 days?
Yeah. I didn't recover for it was a couple days.
We went home that morning, and you could just tell he had to lay down. So much water. I don't think it just wasn't enough water throughout the night. And it really, really just hurt you.
Yeah, no, I was hurting. Hey, but from the previous episodes, we talked about me passing out. I did not pass out.
He did not.
That was a plus. We made progress.
Yes.
That was but Jesse good. Was smart though. He was feeding me bottles of water the next day, and it was water after water. So
yes, you know, I forced him.
I stayed hydrated. Yeah.
So and he did not pee once.
I feel like, yeah, you're right. I was bloated. I was bloated. I was holding all that water in.
That's good, man. That's good.
But yeah, that was my night. What about you? What was a night that you remember? It was just like, man, that was that night.
I've had hundreds, but I think one that maybe that you were there was the time we went to Vegas.
Mm-hmm.
We went to Vegas 100 times, and I think this is when we really didn't have that much money with us.
Yeah.
I think I had about $400 for the whole trip. And we had just got there. We got there pretty late. And I didn't even normally, I'll put my money in the safe. I break it, you know, I kind of spend $100 a day or whatever. Break it in, you know, I proportion it. You remember those days?
I remember this story now, very vividly now. I remember.
So we had just got there. And you were like, oh, let's just go walk around. Let's go, you know, let's go walk. So I'm like, okay. So I didn't get to, you know, take my money. So I had my whole $400 for the whole trip with me. So we were just walking down the strip, and then we went to this, I think it was next to the Harris. It was just this random bar. Yeah. And they had beer pong. I think that's when we started really getting into beer pong.
Yeah.
It was just a vibe. It was just this nice small vibe. So we went in there just to get a drink, and they were having beer pong tournaments, and these German guys couldn't hit the shot. They kept going back and forth with these other Hispanic people. They just couldn't get it. So I said, hey, celebrity shot, let me do it. And they said, all right, surprisingly. So for some reason, I was just on. I made it. Won them the game. They gave me all the beer that was there. I felt like they raised me in the air, but they were just all hyped that they won. So they bought me a couple shots, I think, of peppermint schnapps. And have you ever had that?
No.
It's, think about it like whiskey and toothpaste mixed together.
Mm.
Yeah, just whiskey like and toothpaste.
Sounds like a fireball.
And it's as thick as Jaeger.
Blech.
Yes, that's how I felt. So they gave me a couple shots of that. They may have put something in there. I don't know.
Hey, man, they're trying to holler.
But they they gave me a couple shots of that. I had all that beer. I think we had a couple of drinks that night, and then we were already heading back to the hotel.
Yeah.
So I was telling myself, I need to get to the room because I'm going to black out. And I was so paranoid that I was just going to fall asleep. I had all the money in my pocket for the whole trip, for the whole dang trip. So I told you, I was like, yo, we got to go. We got to go. So we start walking down the strip, and we're just, you're just, this is before Andy Ortiz. This is AO. This is Andy Ortiz.
Tell it like it is, Jesse. It's all
this
good.
This is AO. AO just swagging down the street. AO had this swag. He was just, and he was a little bigger then too. So you were just, you know, you were walking, you know, smooth. And a group of these ladies came and they said something to you and you stopped to talk to them. And I'm like, oh, I can't talk to these girls. I'm about to black out. So I was like, I can have a blackout. And I'm like, come on, guy. I'm like standing. I'm like pacing back and forth. Like, come on. I'm about to black out. So all I remember is you were just taking too much time. So I'm like, F this. I sprinted. I did a full on sprint to the hotel.
I could just imagine you.
I was just gone. I sprinted to the hotel. I made it to the door. As soon as I got to the door, I freaking fell right there and I just knocked out on the floor. I didn't even make it to the bed.
Yeah.
You came in and I was right there on the floor.
I think I remember that now. Yeah.
Yes. And I was just so paranoid that I was going to lose that $400. I just wanted to make sure I got there. And I woke up okay. I guess it was crazy, but it was just that feeling that I had that night at that time, that span of 30 minutes of, oh shoot, you know,
yeah,
we were so cheap. We could have just bought a taxi to go, but no, we were walking. It was about a good mile. Dude, I sprinted.
Hey, that back in the day, like that was us. We would walk everywhere. So for you to run, I could just picture you running in the middle of the night and then just knocking out. But that reminds me of another story, and I'm going to say it. There was this one time that Jesse did not lock the door in our hotel, and it had to have been one of those nights as well, because for you to not have sense to lock the door in our hotel, we were both in the hotel.
Yes.
And that means in the middle of the night, somebody walked inside our hotel while we were sleeping and snooped around while we were sleeping and took Jesse's wallet.
Yep.
Money in it, and that was about what, 400 or 500?
Yeah, I had just won.
He had just won. So that is an example of having one of those nights. Actually, we should have a segment of just Vegas nights, because I think that we've had some fun times in Vegas and we have plenty of stories. That also reminds me, shout out Jesse. When Jesse gave me my flowers the other day, I'm going to give him his flowers right now, because that reminds me of something that he did one time for me when we were in Vegas. I didn't have a job, and I didn't have any money. Like, at that point, I didn't even have any savings. Like, I had no business even coming out the house, because I couldn't probably even go to the mailbox. I couldn't even afford to go to the mailbox and get the mail. That's how broke I was at that point. And Jesse was working at that time, and then he went to Vegas with some friends and whatnot, and he invited me, and I told him straight out, like, man, I don't have no money. And he paid for my trip, and he paid for my meals, and didn't charge me for the room or nothing like that. So, you know, shout out the homie, shout out Jesse. That's why you're my best friend, man. And we all need homies like you. So I appreciate you.
Hey man, you would have done the same.
Yeah, of course.
You've done the same. Nah, there's been plenty of times where I got this. I got this, man. I got this. I got this. But yeah, we have some funny, I appreciate it though, but yeah, we do have some funny stories for Vegas, and I probably could tell one every podcast, so we're going to keep them.
You know what's but the anthem?
I was going to say.
Go ahead.
I was going to say one, but I was like, nah, I'm going to keep it.
Keep it in the tuck. No, but you know what's the anthem for the Vegas, right? I think you know, if you don't remember, what's our anthem song? You don't get it? Oh, it's a
Push It,
Alone in Vegas.
Alone in Vegas.
That's the song right there.
I love that song.
Yeah, man.
Man, Push I love T. that song.
That's the anthem.
That's the anthem, man. But yeah, I'm sure we had a lot of plenty of nights. I'm sure a lot of people could relate to having those crazy nights. I'm sure there's a lot of people that had worse nights. But I think, you know, those probably stand out the most, and that's just hilarious, man, that happened to us. Anything else on that? We're good?
Nah, we good. I think, we should have another segment just on Vegas, just because I don't think they people understand, like, why we probably went to Vegas as much, because we only live 2 hours away. Yeah, so it was a car ride, so no big deal. But we will talk about Vegas more.
What stays in Vegas stays in the podcast.
For sure,
man. All right, so let's get on word on the tweet. Ooh. Where's my bird at? All right. So since we're early in the morning, obviously there's nothing really crazy that happened on Friday. So right now it's Friday Thoughts. And Friday Thoughts, so pretty much it's like motivation. I'm going to read a couple of what people posted.
I got a few here.
Gets you in your vibe. I'm going to read a couple. I'm not going to plug their names in. I'm just going to say so. To find peace, sometimes you have to be willing to lose your communication with people, places, and things that create noise in your life.
Okay.
I see that.
Okay.
I can see that. Go ahead. Give me one.
A random one. Concentrate all your thoughts upon work in hand. The sun rays do not burn until brought to focus. That's deep.
Okay.
All right. Okay. A couple more.
This is probably the deepest one that I've seen.
Go ahead.
Hundreds and hundreds of dolphins at dawn. It's a picture of dolphins.
Are they in Miami?
I don't know what that means, but hey, it feels deep. Go ahead, read one more.
Hold on, I got two more because this is just random. It's gonna be an absolute scorcher of a day today.
Scorcher.
That just sounds like it sounds dirty. Let's see.
Sounds like you need a shower after that day.
It's a scorcher. This one's a cool one. Blessing others as God blesses you will bring positivity even when you're going through.
Okay.
But
how do you feel about these Friday thoughts? Obviously, it's good motivation. People need it. funny thing that to me, I believe motivation, people need it. People need to hear these things. Yeah. If you're going through a tough time, people need to hear it. But I'm going to be that guy. I'm going to say something funny. A lot of it is common sense. It's like, if it's raining outside, grab that umbrella. Like, oh shoot, that's deep, but that's true, right?
That's true.
If it's hot outside, wear a tank top.
if you want to go on a run, wear some sneakers.
Wear some sneakers. I just think a lot of it is common sense, and it's sometimes people need it, but a lot of it, like the one I read. Surround yourself with positive people, right? If you have all that negativity in your life, you're going to have a negative life. That's just common sense.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that?
No, I agree. But common sense, a lot of people don't have common sense. And everybody's common sense is different common sense. So it's just like I told you the last week when we were talking about, like, you know, you have a way of thinking, but not everybody has your way of thinking. But hold on, I'm gonna break it all the way open. So I used to be that guy back in the day on MySpace or even early IG days where I would post a quote. And the quote was really, or motivational quote, was really directed to grab attention towards a certain audience. And that audience back in the day was girls. Because I would say something that would make the girls be like, what's up with this guy? And that would just grab their attention, like, oh, this guy seems wise, or I want to see what's up with him. That was just my bag. I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna keep it 1,000.
The blue in your eyes is bright as the skies.
It wasn't
only if it dies within you.
It wherever wasn't it that
lies, deep. I will lie with you.
Man, if I could go back, I don't even have my DMs no more, just because I think I deleted all them. But I would love to read.
You should.
No, I don't think I have them. I think honestly, I deleted them. But no, I think everybody goes through a stage, and the stages never end. I feel like you just go through these certain moments in life where you need, like you said, you need that motivation. You need to read it. You need to hear it. I've gone through them. There's people that I listen through podcasts. It's just like they feed you motivation all day. But then if you listen to that all day, then are you really like doing the things that they're motivating you to do? Or are you just listening to them? So at some point, you just got to let all that stuff go. And I definitely had my moments where I'll post things on my IG story or on Twitter. And it's like a motivational thing. And it's just for me. And sometimes I go back to it and just reread it and just say, it just like as a reminder, like, all right, yeah, I said that. Did I do that? Am I doing that? Or did I just write that? So it's kind of like an accountability thing for me. But sometimes I'm not, I don't want to see motivation all day. Like, and that's why I don't read people's stories sometimes, just because it's like, come on, man. Like you should, like you just said, and I agree with you and I disagree with you. But I agree with you where it's like, it's common sense. Like, I don't want to read all day saying like grind day or like hump day or like things like that. Like,
yeah,
bro, just get up and do it. Like,
just do it.
Just get up, get out the bed, push your shoes on, go ride a bike, lift some weights, start a business. You know, don't just say like, oh, today's going to be the day where I read a book. Like, but you're writing this on IG. You should be reading the book. And that's one of those things where I feel you need to put action behind your words. And it's awesome to celebrate. It's awesome to like showcase, but do the things to get to that point, and don't just say like you're gonna do it. Do it, and then you could showcase and like let us all know like you know your accomplishments and all that stuff. That's at least my thoughts. But that's coming from a 34-year-old that has, you know, been through that, seen that. And then now I think I know the reality of it. It's just people post stuff for attention, and motivation is cool. And I'm all for it, but I'm not here to read everybody's motivation.
I guess you're right. I don't know why my throat's scratchy. I can see that because I post a lot of my food, right? My healthy food. And I post that, not just as show people, but just to show people like, hey, I'm consistent. Like if I could do it, you could do it. You know, I'm eating healthy. You could do it. There's no excuses. Right. So I think that's why I post. And I guess maybe that could be a form of motivation. You're right. You know, people seeing that, I don't post that just to get any attention. Like people don't want to see turkey and cauliflower rice every day. That's not going to be like, ooh, let me go get that. But if they see that all the time, like, dang, he's on it all the time. Like that could be motivated. Like if he could do it, then I could do it. Maybe that'll push somebody to go eat healthy or change their lifestyle.
Yeah, that's different though. So I think, let me just clarify. I meant more of like quotes. Cause I'll post quotes. Yeah. Cause I'll post pictures just for a vibe. And then I know that you'll post your food just say like, man, I'm eating good. And your food is good. So, oh snap, getting a call. You still there, Jesse?
I'm there.
Okay. So when you post pictures of your food, you know, it's like you want to let us know how good you're eating. And to me, that's fine. I think, honestly, it's just the quotes. I'm not here for the quotes, to be honest with you. I've been that guy to post the quotes too, but I'm not that. Maybe that's just for me though. And if it's for you, totally fine. But right now, like I'm not here.
Andy used to pass. You used to do paragraphs, my guy.
No, I know.
Paragraphs.
No, I know.
I wish we had them, but I know. Yeah, you're right. Nobody wants to see those all day. But I'm over it. Word on the tweet. Friday thoughts.
Friday thoughts.
Those are my thoughts. These are my Friday thoughts. Hey, so we're gonna end it, man. We're right at the 40-minute mark. I know we want to keep it good.
That went quick.
Yeah, we could do this. We could probably do 2 hours if we want, you know?
No, we can't end it, Jesse. We can't end it.
No, I'm going to go. I'm going there.
Oh, yeah, no. I heard, man. The bank called.
The weekly spin.
Yeah, man.
Hold on. Where's the weekly spin?
The wire. Drop? Did the wire go through? Money come through?
We're going to finish this segment, the weekly spins.
I'll go first.
And
I'll go first.
Go ahead.
I'll go first just because I feel like mine is simple. Like I felt like mine was bad because, but yeah. So I've been influenced by the Jordan doc, and I've been talking about looking at Jordans. So I bought some, a pair of, on eBay, and I'm on eBay like crazy. So I bought a pair of 2006 Jordan low shoes, and I got them for $65. They're elephant print, so they're used, but for $65, I couldn't pass them up. And what I'm thinking to do with them is, I think I might hydro dip them. I want to try doing that. And I think they'll look dope on, with some wild colors. For $65, I can afford to like do some fun with it and see how they come out. So when I get that done, I'll make sure to show you guys. I'll show you guys the before and after. And then the other thing that I bought is a pair of 2007 Nike Dunk SB lows. And those I got for $70.
Dunk boys back.
Dunk boys back. Man, I had to let them know because I had dunks. I had dunks way back when.
You were dunk.
Man, I had
before 2004. SB got a hold of them.
2004, 2005. I had a good selection of dunks. I got rid of them, but then I'm like trying to go back in my bag because I know that they're popping off right now, and I'm like, man, I was. Some of them look cool, but I want to.
Those
I
are way get some retro than horses. Ones.
What happened?
Yes.
Okay.
They were way better than Forces.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Because
those Air Forces, those soles are so thick.
Yeah.
Are you gonna get those magenta Jordan 1 lows?
Nah, I'm good.
You're gonna get them?
No. I'm good. All right. But that's my weekly spins. They're coming in. They're ordered. They're not here yet, so they're coming in. But anyways, what are yours?
Mine wasn't as big as yours. Mine was pretty light. I bought a truck.
What kind of truck, man? You got a U-Haul truck?
I got a 2020 Tacoma. Oh, I traded in the Lexus, man. I traded the luxury for the truck bed.
Tacoma boy.
And I love it, man. I had to do something with my other car. It was time for me to trade it in. So I went ahead and purchased a truck. I love it. You know, especially now with the bikes, I could put it in the back. Mm. You know, that's fun. Mm. Everybody always needs a truck family-wise if they want to move a couch, move a fridge. You know, we do a lot of soil here, so I could put some soil in the back.
Oh, man, you're the fridge guy.
Yo, I'm the fridge guy now.
I got a couch. Can I borrow your truck?
Hey, yeah, $30. But I like it, man. It's really nice. It has all the features that I had in my Lexus. I really enjoy it. Can't wait to ride it today. It's my first time riding it to work. But yeah, I bought a truck.
Yeah, that's an expensive weekly spend.
I told Andy on pre-production that I'm doing it for the content. I just went just so I could tell you guys. Hey,
salute Jesse, man. He's doing it for the content.
I'm doing it for myself too, but
I'm over here stressing over like $150. Jesse's over here in the 30,000s, 40,000s. Those are nice though. I'm not gonna lie. Like I'm not a truck guy, but I know when you have a house, like you definitely need a truck. You need something to move things around, and especially with your bikes, it makes sense. And then those, from what I've seen, like they come with all the bells and whistles. Like you have damn near a flat screen TV in there.
Yeah, I got the JBL system. I got a sub in there now.
I'm okay. You bumping.
Okay, so I'm going to break it in today, see how it is.
That's what's up, man. Congratulations, man. That's thanks, dope. Man. I know I'm making fun, but that's dope. That's dope. Yes, sir. You gotta let us know how it feels. Actually, because you're in Texas and you got a truck now, you need the hat, and I need you to put some Longhorns in the front. Like, you need to do the whole nine.
Say less.
Yeah. Actually, because I know you half Mexican, and you know what Mexicans do with their trucks. At the front of the windshield, they put like their last name. You need to put
Jameson.
And then you need to put some stickers that'll chrome out your rear
in old English.
Yeah. Yeah. You gotta do it. You gotta do it. And I need I need a picture on IG.
I'm like this.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, man. Well, thanks for tuning in.
Next week is going to be crazy. I'll tell you about my other weekly spends. It's nuts. Yeah. Nothing crazy, but I already have it.
Oh, nothing crazy. So, you know, I'm going to get a Tesla.
Hey, no, nah, man. I don't have money like that. I don't got money, man. I don't want you guys to think I'm here with money.
Just, hey, I don't say it, but there's rumors out there. Jesse got money. It's just rumors.
That's what my wife said. My wife was like, "You got money." And she said it in a beloved voice, too. So, all right, man. So, next time, let's play this. We didn't get to play the intro, so we'll play it. Take us out.
Daggy.
I'm the real one. Vandy can't help you.
You better win tomorrow.
I'm gonna win.
All right, I'm gonna be in there. $20. I got 20 on Jesse.
Stay tuned. I'm gonna show you a snip.
All right.
Off air. Hey. 45 minutes. Not bad.
Not bad. Hey, anybody out there, everybody out there, subscribe, like, and comment. Follow us, Spotify, Apple Music, Apple Podcasts, I mean, SoundCloud, our Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, you know, so many avenues. But thank you guys for the support so far.
Earth thing, peace.
Earth thing, peace. Y'all be easy.